Hi, this is Gary with MACMOST.com. Did you just see an article about a huge leak of billions of passwords? Don't panic, I'll tell you what to do. So let's say you just saw an article about a huge number of passwords that have just been leaked, and you think, wait a minute, I use passwords. Maybe I'm in some sort of danger here. What should I do? Well, the first thing is, don't panic. You actually see articles like this all the time. You may miss most of them, but sites are constantly publishing articles because they make for great clickbait. In fact, a lot of the articles you see are basically updates month after month of the same password leak. And those leaks themselves aren't actually new leaks. They're just discovered databases of passwords online. The passwords themselves may have actually been leaked years and years ago, and they just keep accumulating. That's why these leaks seem to get bigger and bigger. They include the old passwords as well as maybe some new ones that they found. And sometimes the articles are really vague because it's not just passwords, it's IDs, other personal information, things like that. So they'll show a really big number, but maybe only some of that is passwords. And some may not actually even be passwords, but hashes, which are ways to identify if a password is correct. A leak of a hash really isn't that dangerous. It's the password itself that's the problem. But articles tend to be very vague about this kind of thing. They want you to feel scared. They want you to read the article every time. So the main thing you need to do is don't panic. Just because you see an article like this today doesn't mean you're suddenly in some sort of danger. Here's what you should do. First thing is, you should be using a password manager. If you're not using a password manager by now, you're really behind on security. Password managers do three main things to protect you here. One is they generate strong passwords when you create a new account or change your password at an existing account. It's important to have strong passwords. If you think of the password yourself, it's a weak password, especially if it includes like a name, a date, anything like that. That's easily guessed by an algorithm. A strong password is one that's just a random string of letters and numbers. Next, it allows you to enter the password in easily by inserting it for you. This is important because without that, if you had to type the password yourself, you're going to tend to fall back on shorter, weaker passwords that are easy to remember. It's important that the password manager help you enter your password because that is what allows you to use these strong, unique passwords. And the third thing it does is protect you from phishing attacks. When you are sent to a site that's not the real site, instead of entering in the password to a site that's not the real one, a password manager is simply going to not know what the password is for that site because it's the wrong site. That's a very important aspect of what password managers do. So you should be using a password manager by now. Now, as an Apple user, you're lucky you've got a built-in password manager on all your devices. The Passwords app from Apple provides all the security you need. You certainly can use a third-party password manager if you like, but at least use the Apple password manager. Okay, so you're using a password manager and you've heard about one of these security breaches. How can you check to see if your passwords are affected? Well, any good password manager, including Apple's Passwords app, has a section for this. In the Passwords manager, you go to the security section, and here you can see that it lists any passwords that are compromised. You see, any of these leaked passwords end up in a security database, which a password manager will match to. So it can identify if your password is one of the ones that has been compromised. And this is where you'll find that. If you see one listed here that shows that it's compromised, you know you've got to change that password as soon as possible. You'll also find other warnings here, like if a password's been reused. It's very important that you only use a password at one site. Don't reuse it on other sites. Sometimes you do get a false positive here. Like for instance, Google has many different websites where you could log in using your Google account. But in other cases, you should not be using the same password at unrelated websites that have different accounts. And also, it's going to show any weak passwords here. So passwords that you made years ago and they're not strong passwords randomly generated by your password manager, they'll show here and you can take this opportunity to update those passwords to something stronger. If you find these videos valuable, consider joining the more than 2,000 others that support MacMost at Patreon. You get exclusive content, course discounts, and more. You can read about it at MACMOST.com/Patreon. The other thing you should do is identify any sites that are very important. Things like banks, email accounts, social media, anything that you use on a regular basis. Those should all be using two-factor authentication, where you use a security code generated by an app or by your password manager or maybe received over text. Always use two-factor authentication when it's available. This means that if somebody does have your password, they still can't get into your account. They need that second factor there, that code, to get in. So once you've got all that squared away, all the security alerts taken care of, you're using two-factor at all of the important sites. The other thing you need to worry about is social engineering, basically phishing attacks. This is when you get an email, a text message, or a phone call from somebody who's trying to scam you. So you want to pay really careful attention to these. Make sure you don't give out any information. If somebody says they're sending you a code and they need you to send them back that code, that's a phishing attack. They're actually trying to trigger your two-factor authentication and then getting you to tell them the code. So one last thing I want to address is, what if a site or service isn't listed as a security problem in your password manager? Should you still change the password when you see one of these scary articles? Well, if the password breach does involve a particular site or service and you have an account there, then you want to go to that particular site or service and see what they advise. If it's a true serious threat, then they'll probably be telling people, oh, everybody should update their passwords. And then you do that. Otherwise, whether you update the passwords, it's up to you. If it makes you feel better, you can. But most of us have way too many accounts to be changing our passwords every time we see a scary article. Remember, if you've changed a password recently for a site, and then there's a new leak, chances are they have your old password, not the new one. And hopefully you're protected by two-factor authentication anyway. So it's not always necessary to constantly be changing your passwords every month or so. But it probably is a good idea to, every once in a while, perhaps every month or so, check your security section of your password manager, even if you haven't seen a scary article, just to see if there are any new compromised passwords listed. So to summarize, don't panic. Check the security section of your password manager and stay informed. Thanks for watching. If you liked this video, click the thumbs up button below to let me know. I publish new tutorials each weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out.